Good day, everyone. Hope your week's off to a good start, and thank you for taking time to watch today. Let's start off with prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this time together. Thank you for your holy word. Thank you for prayer. Most of all, thank you for giving your Son on the cross for our sins. And please bless this time together, all to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Again, thank you for taking time to watch today. Something I said last week, and I kind of was hesitant when I said it, I used the word pride, proud that something was occurring. Maybe think of some verses that pride is something we have to be very careful of. I was referring to some of the work going on in the church, and we want to do things that please the Lord. But pride is something that the Bible warns us about again and again, in that if pride in the sense of, you know, look at what I did and I want to be large in charge and in charge and not yield to God. That's not the way I meant it last week, but it did make me think of some verses that I'd like to share today. In particular, I'd like to take a look at the Gospel of Luke chapter 18, verses 9 to 14. And Jesus is speaking here. Two men went up to the temple to pray, sharing a story. And again, Jesus speaking now. He was speaking to some who were confident of their own righteousness. He was speaking to some Pharisees, frankly, who were very prideful. And Jesus shares this story. Two men went up to the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood by himself and prayed, God, I thank you that I am not like other people, robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all that I get. But the tax collector stood at a distance. He would not even look up to heaven, but beat his breast and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. I tell you that this man, the tax collector, rather than the other, the Pharisee, went home justified before God. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. In this story that Jesus shared, it talks about sometimes we forget who we are and who God is. We are the created being. We are the clay. The clay can't say to the potter, why did you make me this way? We need to humble ourselves. One of the things see going on around us today is, while folks saying acknowledging who Jesus is, but really try to bring Jesus down to our level. The book of John, and really throughout all the Gospels, but in John, John is the most personal of the Gospels, I believe. John was the disciple that Jesus loved. But in that, while there's a close relationship that is clear that John has with Jesus, many times, over and over and over, the deity of Christ, in Christ's own words, he shares with us, reminding us, yes, I love you, you're my child, but I'm also God in the flesh, and I was sent here to save you, and those who don't come to accept me as Lord and Savior will by no means enter heaven. Pride, again, going back to the Old Testament, Proverbs 6:16, there are things God hates. In Proverbs 6:16, the Lord shares, Solomon wrote, there are six things the Lord hates, seven are abomination unto him. The first one was a prideful look, a haughty look. The Bible is filled with people who are even champions of faith, who had prideful moments. They had to keep their pride in check. Paul, the apostle who wrote most of the books of the New Testament, had a thorn in the flesh that he prayed that would be taken away from him. And yet the Lord let him know it had to stay because it kept him humble, just like this tax collector from the story Jesus told. Gideon, the army had to be whittled down that was God was going to use for victory on the earth against their enemies. He reminded Gideon then the glory was going to go to God, not Gideon. Yet in the end, Gideon still managed to get a little glory for himself, and it harmed his home, harmed his family line. Job, a very righteous man, and when everything had happened, and was in sorrow. Yet he never cursed God, but he did question what was going on and kept declaring that I have been righteous. Job was saying that about himself, I have been righteous. God reminded him that God is God and that you were not there at the beginning when I created the heavens and earth. And Job certainly yielded to God's authority. Yes, Jesus is our friend, but we should never lose sight of that we are the sinners. He is God in the flesh and died on the cross for our sins. And he is the source of our joy. When we do works, we're doing things for him. It's not for us, for our glory. All things are to God's glory. We're just, right before Jesus told the story about the Pharisee and the tax collector going to the temple to pray. He shared another story that if you do what you're asked to do, you could even say you're an unworthy servant because you're only doing what you're supposed to do. Keep in mind, we serve a risen Lord. Jesus was given by our Heavenly Father to die on the cross for our sins. He alone lived a perfect and sinless life. We need to put him first in all we do and give him the glory. It's not our glory, it's his glory. And we need to thank him every day for his love for us. Now, first step in this relationship is accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. If you've never done so, admit that you're a sinner. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, that he died on the cross for your sins, the perfect sacrifice to wash away our sins. Accept him as Lord and Savior to wash away your sins, and then share that good news with others. If you'd like to join us here at 2271 Altry Mill Road, here in Godwin, North Carolina, at Shiloh Pentecostal Holiness Church, you're certainly welcome to join us. We'd love to have you as you start your journey. Appreciate everyone taking time, and everyone have a great week. Take care.